I feel really good.
How long were you displaced and how were you coping?
It was coping good because, like, it was nearby because, like, it was coming across the king and they did a great job. He promised me that he was going to get me in here before Christmas and he did it. First, though, they did a great job. Yes, from the time I started going out, I started to go and shop. I buy curtains, I buy everything. I just ready. I ready all know.
Where were you staying though?
I was staying by my mom.
By your mom?
Yes, okay. I was staying by my mom.
But you seem quite emotional.
Yeah, it's like emotional because it's my first thing. And that's me. The best gift I ever get.
How difficult was it being, I mean, it sounds a ridiculous question you're asking about how difficult it had been being displaced, but mm-hmm. if you could just verbalize it for me, I mean, being displaced, what was your experience, you know, not being able to be at your own place and having your independence?
Yeah, well, it was uncomfortable because, you know, I have the children, they're small, they're running up and down, you gotta say, start running the door, it's my mom home, but, you know, it's still gonna get space for her, but it was not bad, but I'm glad to be back here on my
First,
own.
Let me say that of the people that had had damage, either fully destroyed or needing repairs, we've been able to satisfy over 340 of those people. What does that mean? That means some people asked for repairs, and we had 220 odd people who have had materials delivered to them. Others, we have done our repairs, and between the freak storm and the Hurricane Elsa, we've done a total and completed a total of 124 repairs for people. And then the rebuilds, this has been the slowest, and we've only completed between the freak storm and the Hurricane Elsa, 13 rebuilds. The problem with the rebuilds has been really the biggest issue has been access to land, because many people are renting land, and from time to time we find that the landlords don't give permission, or they have difficulty getting access, or have difficulty getting their land papers and getting the permission for us to do the land. Apart from that, what we're now finding is access to materials and even access to tools, because the availability of tools, even to be able to rent tools that you don't use all the time, or tools that if tools are broken, because of the shipping logistic problems that we're seeing internationally, we're having some difficulties with tools. And now some contractors, as we were starting to do some of the other foundations for our other program, are even reporting access to workmen. Because we have so many programs going on and so many houses being rebuilt or repaired at this time that even access to workmen is now becoming a problem. So we are continuing. I'm happy that we are able to hand over some of these houses before Christmas. I am unhappy that it is not the numbers that we would have wanted, because obviously I'd been much happier to be able to report that 100 or 150 people were being able to get into their house in advance of Christmas. That is not what we're able to report today, but we're able to report some are getting, and we're working very, very hard to get as many as we can through as quickly as possible. It is not easy. It is quite difficult because there are lots of moving parts and many, many people who want either repairs or rebuilds. But we're prioritizing working through as quickly as we can to get as many done. But more importantly, in this Christmas season, I want to celebrate the contractors that were able to finish this house on budget and on time. And I look forward to this young lady getting her keys and moving in advance of Christmas. I want to have...